agents. In this video, we're going to talk through the crafting station in the Division 2. This is a beginner's guide, so if you are a veteran agent, this video is probably not for you. You probably understand this 100% already. But I play with a lot of beginners at the minute, and they're asking a lot of questions, including questions about the crafting station and how it works. So I've done this video for them. It is a beginner's guide. Before we continue, if you do find this video helpful, I would appreciate the thumbs up on it. And also, I'd appreciate if you check out our video description where you can find out a lot more about us and what we do. We do have a great community in there. The link's at the top of the description. Come and check that out. There's division agents there looking to help you. They're very welcoming. You're just going to love the environment. Just go check it out. Also, if you want to sub to the channel for more content from myself, I'd also really appreciate that. We're so close to 3,000 subs now, and your sub will help us get there. But moving on, the crafting station then. It isn't too complicated at all, but if you are new to this game, it just takes 5 or 10 minutes to get your head around. Now, before you can unlock this, you need to progress in the story. So complete a few missions, you're going to unlock this staff member here at the theater, and then once you spoke to her at the theater, she comes here and this is open. So at that point and only that point onwards, you're able to interact with this and use it. Now, when you interact with the station, this is what you've got here. You've got these options. There's weapons, there's mods, chest, mask, backpack, gloves, knee pads, holster. So the mask, backpack, holster, knee pads, gloves and chest are all your gear pieces, so what you're going around looting and putting your builds together with. Weapons are your weapons you're using, and the mods are the mods that you use to put on your weapons or to put on your gear. So that's all them. You're able to, like in Division 2, create projects. I've not had a go at that yet, but at the top here, as you can see, no active crafting projects. Projects can be created by selecting a blueprint. We'll have a look at that in a minute. On the left side of the screen, which I can't select, you've got blueprints. I've got 51 out of 180. The crafting bench is specialized. The crafting level is 200. Now, it also says crafting bench upgrade. This is new in the Division 2, because in the Division 1, you didn't have to upgrade the bench. So right now, because it's only specialized, when I go into any of these, I'm only going to be seeing specialized options or specialized blueprints. Sorry, blueprints, should I say. Now, we'll go into what these blueprints do in a second. We're first going to talk about the leveling of the bench. Now, as you progress through the Division 2, your level increases, and I'm now in World Tier 4 and my gear score is 450. All of this in here is absolutely pointless to me. The score's 200. I need items of like 450 gear score now. And to do that, you've got to upgrade the crafting bench in order to upgrade those blueprints. And all you got to do there, you can see it flashing at the bottom, is square to upgrade. Now, before you can do that, on the left there, you can see the materials that are required in order to upgrade it. I need 75 receiver components, 75 fabric, and 50 polycarbonate. Now, I do have that, and I also needs to have 2,509 e-credits. So you've got to farm a little for that. If you are just starting the game out and this is the first time you've come to the table, you're not going to be able to upgrade it. But these are actually going to be beneficial to you. So yeah, you can, if you've got the resources, craft these to help you progress further in the game at that point. But what you'll want to do is, as you're progressing through the game and as you're getting enough materials to upgrade this, you want to upgrade it at every opportunity. Because when you get to World Tier 5, which is the true end game, you're going to want this max upgrade so you can be crafting the best stuff. Now, how it also works is that if you find like exotic blueprints out in the open world, they do come in here. I've got a couple myself, these red ones. All these blueprints level up with the level up of the crafting table. So at the minute, if you do see, I don't know, I went out to get the chatterbox gun. So as you can see, I'm able to craft that at the minute. But it's only a score of 290. Now, as I upgrade the crafting table, that score is going to increase as well. So it'll go to the next tier, all the way to World Tier 5, whatever that gear score will be in the end. And that is how it works. You don't need to like farm multiple blueprints. Once you've got the blueprint once, it will upgrade with the table and it will get better with the table. So it is very important to focus on upgrading the table, guys. Make sure you're collecting them materials that you need and make sure you're doing it. We're actually going to do it now. I'm going to show how to upgrade the table. I haven't done it myself, so this is the first time I'm doing it. I'm going to hold square and you'll see now how everything increases. So there you go, I'm now at Superior. The crafting level is 240, so when I go back in here, everything's now 240. It's gone from blue to purple. And my exotics, as I was just discussing, the exotic blueprints that I've got, I've also increased to 290. And that is how it works. So I'm going to go and do that again. Was that 290 before? Sorry, I stumbled there. I don't know. We're going to upgrade it again anyway. I need more materials, but I've already got them. So I'm going to do a second upgrade. And it's now high-end 250. So when I go into weapon, you can see everything's now 250, including the exotics. The chatterbox wasn't a good example to give because it's already higher than my level. That's where the confusion was. But you notice these ones up above have been rising with the level. They're now 250. These won't change until the crafting table's level actually gets over it. As you can see, it's only 250. But I've got enough to upgrade it again, so I'm going to do that. And now it's gone from 250 to 275. So when I go back in here, it's 250 to 275. What that means now, because you haven't got like a guaranteed score, is that it's going to be based on RNG. You'll craft the piece that's in that range. And do I have enough for another update? I sure do. Upgrade rather. Like I said, you're going to be doing this throughout your natural progression. I've been saving it all to do this video. I'm now on 300 to 330. So I'm getting closer to the score I am at currently, and you'll notice now the chatterbox has gone up to 340, which is brilliant. So as I said at the start there, these will upgrade with your table upgades. So what that also means is when you're lower level, if you do go grinding to get these blueprints, you're not going to want to craft them right away. As you can see, I've got all of the stuff I need to craft that, but if I craft that now, it's going to be of a score 340. I want to wait until I've maxed out this table to craft that gun, because then I'll get the gun at its best score. I'm going to go back and do one more upgrade as I'm able to do it. Okay, it's 350 to 3. I'm not going to keep on showing you guns now. I'm just going to keep on upgrading it until I'm not able to upgrade it no more. And there you go. There's no upgrade found. So I've now finally caught up. My crafting level is 400 to 440. That will be matching my world tier that I'm in. I'm in world tier 4. Now, when I get to world tier 5, there'll be another upgrade available for me to get better gear. And we'll have one final look in here. You can see that now everything that I can craft is 400 to 440. And the exotic items that I went out and grinded for is 440. I still don't want to make that, although that will be good for me now if I made that. I'm still waiting to get to world tier 5. When I get to world tier 5, if I was to make that now, it'll be absolutely pointless and I might as well dismantle it. I'd have to go out to get all the parts again to make it. But yeah, that's how the leveling up works. I said I wanted to talk about that in depth first, and that's something that you need to get your head around. You do need to farm those materials, you do need to upgrade the table, otherwise this crafting table will be absolutely pointless. So as long as you understand that, that's the main thing you need to get around first. Now, once you've got your head around that and now you're thinking, okay, you've shown me these gear pieces and guns, I'm still confused, I want to talk about the blueprints now. Now you can see on this screen I've got 15 out of 61 blueprints there, 2 out of 7 there, 1 out of 7, 1 out of 7 all the way across, and 29 out of 77. Now these blueprints you'll find in the open world for like completing missions, completing activities. There's some that are kind of like puzzles in the game where you got to go and find them. I've got separate videos for that. They're mainly your exotic items, but you're unlocking blueprints all the time. Now in Division 1 you're able to buy blueprints. You can't do that in this. I don't think so anyway. I think the vendor sometimes sells a couple. But there used to be an actual blueprint vendor. That blueprint vendor is no more. I do apologize for all these notifications going on, guys. So yeah, that blueprint vendor is no more, and you've just got to complete activities to get them. Now, I've got a separate video, which is the alert level 3 control points. Now, if you go and watch that, I'll link it in the description. That explains how about in World Tier 4, alert control points are unlocked. And if you do an alert 3 control point, you'll get a random blueprint for everyone that you do. So that is a great way of unlocking extra blueprints. Now, the mods are unlocked through that, but also mods you can unlock in a different way, which I want to quickly show you. I'm not going to do a separate video for this because it's so quick to show you. But a lot of your modifications are unlocked from this guy here, and as you're naturally progressing through the game, you've got perks, and here's where a lot of your mods are. So I've got a lot of mods through upgrading that perk, I've got a lot of muzzles for upgrading that perk, I've got the optics, I've got grips, So a lot of your mods can be got from there. So make sure while you are playing for the division, if you are a new person to the game, that you're using your perk points by unlocking these perks and also these mods. Because once they're unlocked, how the mods work is you only ever need to craft them once. You come to the crafting table, you go over to mods, and as you can see, there's a tick on them. I'm going to show you doing this mod now. I haven't done that. It's a small RDS scope. I just press square to craft it. As long as I've got the materials, I obviously need to have them. And there you go, I've crafted that modification, and that's unlocked now forever. I can put that on any weapon that it's able to go on, and that's all I have to do. Just collect the blueprint and craft it, and that's done. It's different to how it worked in the Division 1 with mods. Mods used to be part of the drop rate with like gear and weapons. This is a much better way of doing it. You just need to unlock the blueprint and then craft it, and it's unlocked forever. As you can see, I've got a tick on everything now. And there's loads more to get. I'm only 29 out of 77, so I need to keep on doing those tier 3 control points or alert tier 3 to keep unlocking as much as I can, because there's some mods that are really, really good for your weapons that are going to give you the advantage. Now, that's the only one that works like that. The weapons and all the gear will just be got through completing missions. More of those mods will be got through that as well, but what I'm saying is you can't, there's no way of unlocking extra gear pieces or weapons. They are only got through RNG via missions or whatnot. Now, some missions will state what modification you are going to unlock, so just hover over the mission before you start and it'll tell you what you're going to get. But what we're going to go on to now is, what do you do when they're all here? So you can see I've not unlocked a lot at all, but I do have 15 weapon blueprints, and yeah, they're just here. So let's say you've just gone up a world tier, you've upgraded your crafting table, and the best weapon you've got is still 301 gear score. Well, you can come in here, you can have a look at the blueprints you got, and I might be, oh, I want an assault rifle that's higher. I would just come here, make sure I've got the materials, and craft it. Now, on the right side there, you've got the materials required, which is steel, carbon, and receiver components. As long as you've got enough to do that, you're able to hold square, and you're able to craft the item. And that goes in your inventory at a random gear score of 400 to 440, which will beat your 300 gear score weapon that you got now. And that's the best way of using this crafting bench, to be fair, to start off with, because it's personally, I'm only going to want to use it when I move up world tier, because I've got such low score, and it's an opportunity to craft some items without having to go out and grind for it. And it's a great thing to do at the start of every world tier. But the other reason I'm going to use a crafting station is for all these exotic blueprints that I'm going to find. Now, it seems to be that there's going to be quite a few in the game. I've already done the requirements to get the Lost Chatterbox and to get the Kendra's Liberty pistol. I'm not going to craft them yet, because I'm going to do separate videos on these to show you how you get these blueprints. But again, as I was saying earlier, I want a maxed out table. I want to get these crafted at the highest score possible. And that's when this table is going to become useful for me. Say I'm like a division veteran agent and I like grinding. I'll very rarely use this crafting table. I've only used it so far to do the mods for the weapons, because I've wanted to put mods on my weapons, and that's it. But from when I do max it out, I will be going through all these exotic blueprints, and I'll be coming here to craft them. And I think that's it for the video. I don't think there's anything more to explain about the crafting station. It's just there to benefit those people that want a little jump start on a world tier, I'd say. Or if there is, there is one more thing to discuss, and that is obviously the rolls on your weapons. So say you like a particular weapon, this is another great use of this bench. Let's say my favorite weapon was the FAMAS. It's not, but let's say it was. I had a FAMAS, but I didn't like what the random talents were. What I could do if I had this maxed out is keep on crafting one until it came out with talents that I liked. It saves a lot of time, because if I'm going to loop missions, if I'm going to loop the world, how often will a FAMAS drop for me at the score I want it? Not that often. So then how often will it drop of the attributes that I want? Even less so. So this is a better way of getting that, because if I've got the resources to do it, which I will when I constantly grind the game, with the Division 1 I had unlimited resources, I can craft what I want, I will get to that point again. I can just craft this over and over until I craft one that gives me the talents that I want. That is another great use for this table as you get into end game, and that is what you'll be using it for as well. So but that really is it. Now, there's not really much more I can discuss about it. That is that. If this video has helped, please do hit like. like, I'd appreciate it. And do check out the video description, because in there, there's links to everything else that I do, including our community. Do go and check that out if you want Division agents to play with. They're very, very helpful. It's very welcoming. Yeah, you'll love it there. Don't forget to hit sub on the channel if you want to watch more videos from myself. I'd also appreciate that. But until the next video, thank you for watching this one, guys, and peace out.